Stalker Patti, yeah.
Hey, how are you?
Oh, here's one that was down there.
Yes, I was there.
The new hairless, nippled Stalker Patti.
I'm still not done yet. I got two more points to go.
Hey, Patti. One of our faithful listeners gave us Zoloft last night.
Gave us a big, like, starter package of Zoloft.
This is a true story.
Now, I don't know what Zoloft is.
I take it to keep from killing y'all.
Patti, I know you want to be close to the show and stuff. If you come down here right now and take some Zoloft,
Opie, we cannot dispense prescription medicine on this show.
I don't take any kind
of. We want to give the Zoloft to someone to see what it does to a person.
Yeah. No,
would you be willing to come down and OD on Zoloft?
No.
I don't think we can dispense narcotics.
I'm on the Zoloft thing, right? But I'm on that to keep me from killing y'all.
No.
Thank God for the Zoloft.
So you will not come down here and take some Zoloft?
No, I won't, because that would hurt my body.
Well, your body's hurting.
Things
are pretty hurting already.
What do you mean by that?
Would you actually accept Opie as your first love, your first lover, your first F?
Now, you're talking nonsense, okay?
She didn't say no.
No, I wouldn't.
Why not? Don't you like his personality?
Oh, I love you both. I really do.
Don't you,
but not in that way.
Wouldn't you like to have him take away that blessed virginity
of
yours?
I would rather meet somebody who's unattached and, you know, somebody that I care about very much, you know, like in the future, someday that
will
happen.
In the future. Talking about the Jetsons' future.
Patti, you're 45. You've never made out with the guy. What are you waiting for?
I'm waiting for to meet the right person. I've never had that opportunity.
Most girls
you got to understand my background, too. I come from a very...
Oh, you like a McEaster?
No.
I thought that's what you meant by background.
I come from a church background. And I've been sort of like, in the 80s when I graduated college, I was... at work a lot, and I kind of isolated myself, so I didn't get much of a social life either.
A church background,
and
so you're into young boys?
Were you molested by a priest or a nun?
No.
No.
It's just that I was living among people that would make you feel like when you were young that the Lord would strike you dead.
Oh,
or
God.
Well,
like
Patti,
that,
Patti, he will.
So it's like you never have the opportunity to actually socialize.
Anthony, I got to read one of Rick's lines.
Okay.
Her unpopped, rotten cherry that looks like a removed tonsil.
What?
Oh, God, that's horrible.
What?
You know something, Patti? Most girls save their virginity because it is such a precious gift to the man. But at your age now, it's going to be like giving away, I don't know, a 72 Buick. You know what I mean? It's not that precious a gift anymore.
Mm.
You know? And the longer you wait, the less precious it gets. People would rather have a McDonald's apple pie.
Well, Anthony, that moment will come, I'm sure, with the right person,
I don't think so.
Can we get you a banging?
You just got to let loose, because I don't think you're going to find the guy that you're looking for the way you're looking. You have no social life, so you don't really mingle and meet people that you might come across this dream guy.
I know I get intimidated when I go into places like a bar. I've gone in to use the restroom and come out, but I don't drink, you know, or anything. So.
Yeah, that helps. Especially for the guy.
I don't drink for medical reasons.
Be on drugs.
I don't know why you gotta be so mean. Because I don't do anything to...
Usually when I'm mean to someone, they get the hint and they leave me alone.
No, it's attention that you're giving her. When you're mean,
yeah,
it's just attention. Doesn't matter. Good attention, bad attention. You're giving her attention.
Oh.
And she takes that as some type of relationship.
Hello?
That you two have.
Hello?
Right,
I don't
Patti?
Think that's right.
I do.
No.
Shut up, bitch. That's funny.
No, I don't think I'm that type of a person.
Dave, what's up?
Dude, how you doing?
Hey.
Listen, you know, she's really like a virgin or something like that.
Yeah.
And she's like 45 years old. You know, like when you're like 15 and you're going to go on your first date, you know, and you're a girl or something like that, and it happens, and there's, you know, like it's just a little bit of pressure. and it pops. You know?
Yeah.
Well,
I'm with you.
She's 45 years old, man. It's like rawhide now.
Rawhide.
Dude, you'll have to take a sauce all to that.
Patti, you got to dust off that peach and, crack it open.
You ever watch the Discovery Channel and they have the mummies that they bring up and they're naked, you know? Because they're naked. And they pan down and you're like, oh, look at mummy genitals. Patti, do you have mummy genitals?
No.
Check to see if there's like an ancient Egyptian beer cap in there.
Hey, Patti.
What?
If we invite you down here, can we take a look at your peach?
No.
Don't buy that pen.
No.
I want to see what's nastier, Sandy Kane's hemorrhoid-ridden ass or your peach.
No. I can't do that. I'm embarrassed.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
You got a lot of growth?
No.
No?
No.
Do you keep it nice and clean?
Yes, I do. I have very good hygiene.
Hygiene?
Yes.
Not very good genes, very good hygiene.
And not hygiene, it's hygiene.
Hygiene.
That's the accent on the wrong syllable.
Is Gene your boyfriend?
What?
Hygiene. Hygiene.
What, do you scrub that thing?
Well, no more than anybody would in a shower.
Hey, Patti, does your cherry have fruit flies?
No.
That's horrible.
Hey, Patti, have you ever had an orgasm?
Oh, that's a good
thing. Well, I have the urges about 10 days after my monthly. That's about it.
Wait a minute. Oh, she's got the urges 10 days.
Use it or lose it.
What does that even mean?
What? You get urges when?
About 10 days. You know what? Every woman gets that, though. That's normal.
I think they get urges more than
once
that.
A month. So these urges, do you take care of them manually, if you know what I mean?
Patti.
What?
What do you do when these urges come on?
They usually pass.
But don't you, like, take care of it?
Well, I don't talk about it.
Oh, my. Do it. Do it. Come on. Come on. Kill me. I'm here. Come here. I'm here. Kill me. Come on. Kill me. I'm here. Come on. Do it now. Kill me.
Even Arnold can't take this conversation.
Patti.
Yes?
You take care of your urges. How do you take care of your urges? I think this is going to be hot.
Yeah.
You know, that's not an easy subject for me to talk about.
What do you do?
Backwards.
What do you do to take care of those urges?
Trust me, no one is listening to this anymore.
You're getting the finger banging, old Mary Jane Rotten Crotch through her pretty pink panties are over.
So, Patti.
I'm just normal like everybody else.
Is it your hand? Do you do a little of what they call the diddle?
Do you diddle the, you know.
I'm embarrassed. You're really embarrassing me.
That's all right.
I hope you clean your fingernails afterwards.
Oh. Oh, my God.
Oh, you just... Look, I'm very hygienic.
I hope you're not serving any Big Macs after that.
No.
Oh, God. I'm getting an urge, and I have to serve up some Big Mac. Look at this. I got some special sauce in my panties.
Oh. Shut up! Shut up! So, Patti, the urge comes
got
on.
Milk. Got milk?
Patti.
Yeah, you like to
what?
Suck my ass!
What?
So the urges come on, what, 10 days after your little friend arrived?
Yes.
All right.
Oh,
so you're laying all alone at home, and what happens?
Well, I don't know what normal people do, I guess.
Oh, my God. Patti.
But I'm not.
Patti, let me tell you something right now.
What?
And trust me, I hate you. But if you take us through your masturbation habit here.
Yeah.
Not only will I buy...
I don't have a habit.
Not only will I buy you breakfast at the Brooklyn Diner, I will sit with you and enjoy your company.
Nice. So what do you do to you satisfy these urges?
How do I do it?
Yeah.
Well,
run us through it.
Fantasy, I guess.
Yeah, baby.
You know, I think of, like, maybe cute guys or something.
Oh, do I
know?
Make you horny?
Or imagine that.
Don't even ask the question. All right. You imagine cute guys.
And leave it at that, Ed.
Patti, can I just ask you one question?
Sure.
And be honest.
Sure.
And be honest, because we're all friends here, Patti.
Okay.
I turned off your mic. No one could hear you, Anthony.
Patti?
Yes?
Have you ever... And be honest, we're just friends talking on the phone.
Yes.
Have you ever used Opie in any of these fantasies in any way, shape, or form? Be honest.
No, never. Because the minute I... Well, let me tell you something. I was raised in an atmosphere like, you know, like through the church and everything to respect, you know, people who are... in relationships and things, and then, you know, if I have a crush on a guy and I know they're seeing somebody or with somebody, a significant other married, a wall comes down, a gate comes across, the boundary is drawn, I
Holy
take a friendship
yes.
in a different direction. I fantasize about single guys.
Patti, you can't even fantasize about somebody that isn't available in some way.
Patti, religion has F's you up.
Yeah, this is a perfect example of religion.
The stuff that goes through my mind when I'm alone, there's no barriers.
Wow.
Well, I do throw up barriers only because of respect.
Oh, all right.
But it's a fantasy.
All right. Well, Anthony, thank you for asking that question. That's a big relief to me.
Yeah.
Oh, by the way, I want to announce that I am I'm getting married.
Oh, thank you, Lord. Praise Jesus.
Just to make sure there's no doubt in Patty's mind.
Opie, I respect everybody.
All right, Patti, so you get the urge.
Yes.
You're laying on that that flea infested mattress of yours.
It is not flea.
In that serial killer apartment of yours.
Can you see every painful detail of my muscular physique?
And what happens? You're laying there alone.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
What happens? Breakfast at the Brooklyn Diner, up for grabs.
The following program is intended for mature audiences.
What do I do?
Yeah.
Well?
Virgin.
Just, like, visualize, you know, like...
Okay, so you visualize, you get the fantasy in your head,
yeah.
Maybe you shut your eyes.
Right.
And then what happens there to satisfy the urge? Because you know where the urge is based around, you know what I mean?
Yeah, definitely. It's a physical urge.
Right.
Pussy!
You know?
So what do you do to take care of that?
Well, I visualize, like, maybe somebody, like, an actor, a singer, or something I know.
And what are they doing in these fantasies that you have?
Name an actor that you have fantasized over.
Okay, a musician.
Which one?
I've had a crush on The Edge for like 15 years now.
The Edge from U2.
Yeah, I actually love the band, and I've had a crush on him for a long time because
wow.
he's cute.
Hey, well, we got The Edge right here on the phone. Edge! What are you... Oh, my God. What happened? The Edge just shot himself. Oh, my God. Oh, no. Bono just took himself out, too, by association.
Patti?
Yes?
All right. So you're on your mattress, I assume, at this point?
Yeah.
Are you naked?
Be honest.
Well, I guess. You know.
Yeah.
Yeah, baby.
You know. Especially, you know, like it's just, you know, it's just a fantasy. It isn't real, and that's what makes it safe.
Heinous it. Heinous it.
Butt sex.
Heinous it.
You're a silky whore.
You use your tongue prettier than a $20 whore.
You know, but don't. Hello?
Yeah.
Now, don't get me wrong. I don't have a dirty mind or anything.
It looks like I'm a rat. It's in the hole.
So what are you,
Those men wanted to have sex with me.
What do you do? What do you think about? What do you imagine The Edge doing that satisfies some of these fantasies?
Making love to you.
Oh, well, making love to you.
Yeah.
So what type of, like, what's the move? Do you see him at a concert? He invites you backstage? What's the move?
Well, I mean, you know,
What's the fantasy about?
Well, I meet him like a regular person, and I envision going out with him and whatever, you know, but that's only a fantasy. It'll never happen.
You ever seen a grown man naked?
Does the edge take you out for some ice cream?
Well, no, more like dinner and roses is more like it.
All right.
Anthony, through the magic of radio,
yeah,
we have entered Stalker Patty's fantasy mind.
Right, and I do believe we have audio of the edge. All right.
I smell vermin, Poontang.
Oh, my God.
All right, so now you're with the edge.
Yeah.
He's making love to you. Is it on your bed, familiar surroundings? Is it a posh hotel?
Actually, I tend to take myself out of familiar surroundings and put myself in a hotel room, a neutral area.
All right, so you're in a hotel with the edge. And then obviously you're not just all of a sudden naked and making love with the edge from you, too. There's got to be some kind of a setup. So you're in the hotel. What happens? Because you don't drink or anything. You're talking. Does he start rubbing you? How does
Hey, everybody, we're all going to get laid.
Yeah.
How does this pan out?
Well, it pans
out. What?
Oh, my face is red. You know, it's still like a little, you know, hugging and stuff
hugging,
like that.
Hugging, a little rubbing.
You know, and whatever.
So do you then like grab his junk or something? What? How does the sexual part of this start up?
Well, I would let him take the lead.
Yeah. So,
you know? Oh, and Anthony, with that, I do believe we have more audio from the edge.
All right.
You're a little bitch. That's right. You're a bitch, and I bet you'd like to suck it, wouldn't you?
Wow.
You know, plus, you know, I read magazines like Cosmopolitan. And,
Cosmopolitan.
You know, I get a little insight into that, you know. I'm not into the romance-type stories, but I like reading about real-life situations.
Uh-huh.
So, you know, and then I imagine some of those situations that I read about.
Anthony?
Yeah.
More audio from the edge.
You look like 2 miles of bad road.
Is it true that, they wrote Sunday Bloody Sunday about you?
No, that was about a political situation in Ireland in 1971.
I thought it was a few days before your urges.
Oh, stop.
Okay. Well, you know, it's my mistake. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
So now he makes the first move. What does he do to make this first sexual move toward you?
Essentially, we just go right into the bed. That's all.
All right, into the bed. Now you're rubbing each other and touching. And he's touching the does he start now touching your naughty parts?
Well, not right away, you know.
No, I know, but we're up to that.
And one pathetic loser.
So now,
yeah.
Now you're naked. You're in bed with the edge.
Yeah.
And you're rubbing each other, and you're rubbing each other's little naughty parts. Since you've never had sex before, how do you imagine the act of having sex?
Very gentle and sweet.
But, I mean, how do you even know what would be done if you've never had sex before?
Well,
have you seen it in maybe some pornographic movies, Patty?
Actually, once in a while, I watched them just out of curiosity.
Oh, so you've seen one. So you've seen the act, so you know what it would look like.
Yeah, well, I just imitate my mind from those things.
So what is it, what is your fantasy and your urges and your body feel like when at the edge plants one?
How does the edge take you, Patty?
Yeah.
Does he take you from behind? Do you ride him?
Something tells me it's pure missionary.
You got that right.
Ah, Patty on the bottom.
Yeah.
The edge on top, pulling right. That wool cap over his own face.
Because I'm going to tell you, some of the positions that I see pictured in Cosmopolitan magazine, I really don't think I could get into
them. Yeah, well, Patty, slow down.
Yeah, there are some wild positions in Cosmopolitan.
Cosmopolitan.
I don't understand how she bends over with that sweater on.
Pat, do you read those articles? How to satisfy your man.
No, I've seen some of the weirdest things with legs up on the table and stuff.
Oh, yeah, that's weird.
Yeah,
that's pretty wacky.
Yeah, that sucks when that happens.
So, all right, you're doing it with the edge in your fantasy.
Missionary now, position.
Missionary position, and it's very nice and soft and sweet. Now, just the image in your head and the fantasy can't be enough to satisfy you. Your hands now start to roam a little bit, right?
Right. Well,
no, Patti, it's perfectly normal that people touch themselves. They get into that. It goes hand in hand with the fantasy. So what do? You start on your shoulders a little bit. Give us the rundown of what it's like.
Well, you know, it's from kissing me and stuff like that. And,
yeah, but what are you doing? What are you doing?
What are you
with
doing
hands?
While you're fantasizing this? What? Anthony, by the way, we have audio of The Edge.
The Edge, again, okay.
In the middle of having sex with Stalker Patti and Patty's fantasy.
All right.
Torture! It's torture!
Wow, The Edge sounds a lot like Psycho Mark.
Well, no, I mean,
just my ass!
Wow, I didn't know we had audio of Patti.
Stick it in my mouth.
Patti, do you ever fantasize about that?
Actually, no. I can't imagine doing it. It's got to be yucky.
The Edge is standing there.
Wait, what's got to be yucky?
This one.
Stick it in my mouth.
She wouldn't imagine
that's
that.
It's not attractive.
Is the Edge into a
butt sex?
Any of that?
No.
Flipping you over or nothing?
Patti, we want to know if you're, like, petting the poodle at this point.
Yeah, now, no. Patti, let's get down to brass tacks here. Has your hand ventured below your waist during this fantasy? You're alone, you're at home, you're naked, you're fantasizing. Does your hand now go below your waist?
Well, you know, like I said, I have a certain degree of modesty, but
we're all friends here.
Yeah,
it does. It does.
Vagina.
Yes.
You do the three-knuckle shuffle?
How many, Patti? Just give me a number, 1 through 5. How many? You know what I mean. How many?
Well, just what I've seen on TV, but...
She'd be lucky to get
I'm a lady, you know? You know, it's not easy for me to talk about stuff like that because I am a lady.
You know, do you know something?
What?
We have single-handedly ruined you two for everyone listening out there.
I believe you two wrote this song with Stalker Patti and Molly.
Oh, you think so?
Yes.
The sweetest thing. Oh, my God. All right. Well, that's a
good,
hot...
Baby. Very good.
That's a hot story, Patti.
Yeah, but...
You know, and I think it's pretty freeing for you to be able to talk openly about your fantasies like that.
Yeah, but it's embarrassing.
You know, well, that's something you got to get out of because religion's really effed you up like that.
Mm-hmm.
Anthony, you know, I'll be having fun.
Anthony, you know what's strange after hearing a story like this that a girl tells on our show? I usually have to run to the bathroom for little, you know what?
Yeah.
I can't find my junk.
Oh, he's a comedian.
Opie, I've made this announcement numerous times in a joking fashion, but I'd like to make it now in all seriousness.
Yeah.
I am completely gay. I have turned today completely homosexual.
Oh, I don't get it.
Chris on line 10, I wish someone would push Patti over the edge.
What do they mean by that?
A little play on words.
Because I'm not a bad person or anything.
Oh, no.
Patti, can I tell you something?
What?
Because I was brought up with religion as well.
Yeah.
Lady Queen of Martyrs in Centerport, my church of worship.
Yeah.
Really. Patti?
What?
Because you had those thoughts.
Yeah.
You are going to hell.
Yeah. Yeah, Patti, by the way, you're very, forgot to fill you in there.
You're a very dirty, naughty girl.
No, I'm not. No, I'm not.
I just want everybody to get that scene in their head. Patti laying on her bed, naked, diddling to the edge.
The thing is, I'm a lady. I respect relationships. I value them.
Patti isn't going out with anyone?
Patti, let me let you in on a little secret. Ladies love to bang, too.
Yeah. What?
Ladies love to bang, too.
Yeah, with the people that they love.
Sometimes, sure.
Wow. That was pretty gross.
You know, but I would be very careful about being active because AIDS and everything else.
Dirty girl. Yeah, you like that, don't you, bitch? Yeah, that's hot. You take it. You take it now.
Dirty girl. You're a little bitch. That's right, you're a bitch, and I bet you'd like to suck it.
Well, dirty girl.
Ugly motherfucker.
Stay out the bushes.
Dirty girl.
Don't just stare at it, eat it.
Oh my God.
You're brutal.
Well, thanks, Patti, for that.
Yeah, Patti, that was
for that hour of hot radio.
Rich, what's up?
Yo, guys, man, you're killing me here. I'm trying to eat you, for God's sakes. I'd rather have Arnold Schwarzenegger fist me than listen to Walker Patti molesting herself on the bed. Jesus Christ, man.
To the edge. I love when the listeners get pissed off.
Oh, Mother McCree. I mean, I think the Edge just cut his throat over there in England or wherever the hell he is.
All right, Patti.
What?
Do you go to confession still?
No, I haven't been to church in like 3 or 4 years.
Oh, yeah.
So what's the point of saving it? Give it up. Give up the back door, something. Jesus Christ.
All right. Thank you, Rich.
No problem.
Bye.
Bye.
I don't want to do that with somebody unless they're very special to
me. Shut up with that crap. I just always hang out at backstage at the U2 shows. I'm a roadie. I just happen to be here. Frank, what's up?
For the love of God, you two, shut her up. The thought of her diddling her Dust Bowl makes me want to stick my junk in a meat grinder. Not the electric kind, the old hand cranked.
Don't beat around the bush.
So I can, like, get the maximum pain so I can forget this vision that's in my freaking head. Turn it.
I think he was going into
turn it off.
Yes. Well, Patti, is it true that a baby fell into your most intimate and the town rallied to pull it out?
No.
Did it look like the mine shaft all boarded up with cobwebs and an old rail car? No?
No.
All right, I'm just wondering. All right, Patti.
Okay.
Opie, this just in, I'm checking out on MTV Music News. U2 is broken up, The Edge in hiding.
Okay. All right.
Okay.
You people are horrible. If she ever had the big O, it would probably flow like curdled milk.
Don from East Meadow.
Don, that's horrible.